Hey guys, welcome back. It's Temmie here. So I just got home from school. I'm gonna be heading to the gym in about 45 minutes to an hour's time. I've already had lunch, and so I'm just gonna be making myself a quick little snack before I head off to the gym. I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys what I'm gonna be having. It's just gonna be a little bowl of fruit, nothing too crazy. So in this little bowl of fruit, we have some bananas, blueberries, blackberries, a little bit of cantaloupe or melon. I know some people call it different names. And then a little bit of a green pear. So it's a perfect for really good source of energy. There is a lot of carbs in here, but I am doing legs today. And so I've been carb cycling and pairing high carb days with leg days. So this is perfect for this. For breakfast, I had oatmeal. And then for lunch, I had that quinoa apple salad, just in case you guys are interested. And then for dinner, I'm planning on having some green beans, sweet potatoes, and some cod. So I'll show you guys what that looks like later on. But I'm gonna go ahead and scarf this down and then show you guys what my outfit is. And then we're gonna head off to the gym. So I've relocated to my bedroom to finish the rest of this fruit bowl. I'm just gonna catch up on some YouTube videos that I haven't been able to watch because I've been busy with life and school starting. And so that's what I'm gonna do because I've got time to kill. One of my friends is coming with me to film this video, so I have to wait for her to get here before I can even leave. So we got time. And I also wanted to talk a little bit about this workout. Give you guys a little bit more information. I don't even know where I was going with that first sentence, but yeah. I just want to give you guys more information about it. This shirt is sitting really funny right now. I think it's just the way I'm laying too, though. Probably Tem. But anyways. This workout is a leg workout, but it does have a strong glute focus. It still targets all the muscle groups on my lower body, though. It's just there is a stronger glute focus to it, which is because I'm chasing those booty gains. I've said it time and time again, so if you know me, you know that. I'm always chasing those booty gains, and so my leg workouts typically tend to have a strong glute focus. And I also like to combine both compound and isolate exercises. I feel like I get the best results from that as opposed to separating them into two separate workouts. So this workout is my light leg day workout, and then I lift heavy on legs twice a week. So in total, I have 3 leg day workouts. One's light, 2 are heavy. And this light leg day one can be done at home. The only exercise I think that you might have difficulty with is the Goodmornings, but as long as you have weights such as dumbbells or anything heavy, really, you can do this workout from the comfort of your own home. I've done this workout at home before when it was just too snowy and too cold for me to go to the gym because I'm a little bish when it comes to the cold. You can do this workout at home. I don't use any machines in it at all. For my heavy leg day workouts, I do use a few more machines, but still not as much as others. What else was I going to say? I keep getting like brain farts, if you guys can tell. What else was I going to say? Yes, resistance bands. Okay, so this workout has a strong focus on resistance bands, and I don't use them for every single exercise, even though you can. I just feel like some exercises don't need them because why I use them is to up the intensity and to really engage my glute muscles and also to keep tension all the way through as I'm doing whatever exercise it is that I'm doing. And so for some of them, it's just not necessary. It's already pretty intense or it's not necessary. Whereas with some, I just need further glute activation. So I don't use them for every single exercise. You guys can definitely add them to some of the exercises that I didn't use them for. I will say though, resistance bands are no joke. I feel like people kind of think they are when they haven't tried them yet. They honestly are not a joke. They look like a breeze, but that's not the case at all. And so I wouldn't add them to every single exercise. You will be sore for days on end. I was sore for days on end when I first started using resistance bands because I would use them for pretty much every single exercise. And you guys, I'm not even over-exaggerating when I would say, like, I was walking funny for days. People would notice, like, a lot of people knew that it was, like, workout-related, but I definitely got a lot of comments and questions. So, just be careful. That's all I gotta say. So, I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys my outfit. Alright, so for an outfit, I'm just wearing this black workout tank. I believe it's from Forever 21, and it's, like, a cutout style tank. And then, just wearing this black sports bra. Just looks like so, and it is from Victoria's Secret. Super comfy, has lots of padding, as you can tell. The shirt is really comfy, but moves around so much, like so much. So it's comfy, but a little annoying, I'm not even gonna lie. And then for pants, I'm just wearing these Lululemon Lycra leggings that just look like so. Yeah, that's pretty much it. So this is just what my workout outfit of the day is. I love to wear black, if you haven't already picked that up. I love to wear black. I own a lot of black, both regular and workout clothes, and so I wear lots of black. Almost on the daily, I wanna say, but yeah. So I'm gonna go ahead and see you guys at the gym. So lately I've been starting my workouts out with 5 minutes of stretching instead of warming up on the elliptical. And then right away, I like to move into the toe taps, and I like to do 3 sets of 20 of these. And these are pretty straightforward. All you need to do is keep your leg straight as you are lowering it down on either side. This exercise does a really great job of waking up those glutes and getting them activated. Then I like to superset these with some straight leg Goodmornings with a barbell, and I like to do 3 sets of 25 reps. And these are like one of my favorite leg exercises to do. It not only targets your legs, glutes, and upper hamstrings, but your lower back muscles as well. So I do like to do this on upper body days sometimes. With the Goodmornings, you just want to try and keep your legs straight. A slight knee bend is fine. But yeah, you just really want to keep your legs as straight as possible as you bend down towards a 90 degree angle. Moving on to banded side steps, I like to use my second heaviest pair of bands, and I also like to hold a small weight for this exercise as well, just to up the intensity, and I just like to hold it a few inches away from my chest. And if you really feel like working those delts at the same time, then you can just hold the weight a little bit further away, and that's going to target your legs in general, glutes, and your deltoids. I like to superset these with some goblet squats with some pulses, 2 to be exact, and I do 12 reps of these. And I also like to use with my legs in a V stance because this allows for more glute activation. And I use my heaviest resistance bands for these so I can really feel the burn. The pulses in between the squats make this exercise literally 10 times harder, but I prefer to do them with the pulses just because I feel the burn 10 times more than I do without the pulses. So definitely recommend them. Moving on to single leg Romanian deadlifts, I like to do 3 sets of 10 of these. But these ones, you guys, you just want to start off by focusing on balance and then adding light weight when you feel like you really have the balance part down pat. To help with balance, I like to place my finger in my belly button. For some unknown reason to me, you guys, it seems to work. So try that out. Stick your finger in your belly button and it'll keep you grounded and centered as you are lowering the dumbbell towards the ground and kicking back at the exact same time. At the top of your kick, you want to squeeze those glute muscles. I know it's a little difficult to do when you're worrying about balancing, but squeezing will further engage those glute muscles. I like to superset those RDLs with either some jump squats with a band or some box jumps. Either or, today I decided on some jump squats and I'm doing 20 reps. Sometimes I'll even do 40 if I'm feeling a little wild. Today was definitely not one of those days. I struggled to get through this workout actually, so just stuck with the 20 and did 3 sets of those. Jumps in general are a really good way to add in little bursts of cardio, and so that's why I like to incorporate them in, just to mix in a little bit of like strength training and some cardio at the same time. The next exercise I like to do are banded glute kickbacks, and I like to do 20 reps of these. And I place the band on a spot right below my calf muscles and right above my Achilles tendon, and that works really well. I find that anything above or below, then it gets kind of hard to actually do the kickback motion.
And then at the top of your kick, you really want to squeeze those glute muscles, even if it's just for a second. I superset these with a box squat, and I like to hold a weight while I do these. You can hold the weight above your head, but I like developing my delts every chance I get, so I like to hold them out straight ahead. You can also use dumbbells instead, but I prefer plates. Box squats are really straightforward. All you're trying to do is just lower your body down to the point where you're just hovering a couple inches above the box and then bringing yourself right back up again and doing it 12 or so times. And because stretching is really important, I've been stretching before and after my workouts. I wasn't actually able to film the before portion, but I've been stretching before and after my workouts and I've been seeing such awesome results. I'm hardly ever sore anymore, which is awesome. I mainly focus on stretching out my hip flexors because they are so tight at the end of the workout. And then I also like to roll out my muscles to release any built up tension. I highly, highly, highly recommend stretching and rolling out your muscles. It will make all the difference in the recovery period. I like to wrap up my leg day by showering and hopping in the sauna. It's really great for your muscles post-workout because it helps relieve sore muscles as well as it allows for you to shed excess water weight. And I usually sit in here for around 5 to 10 minutes. I'm just gonna be making some cod, green beans, and sweet potatoes. And the cod has about 16 grams of protein in it. I'm going to be baking this. I'm gonna pan fry this and I'm going to boil some sweet potatoes, I think, rather than baking it. Sweet potatoes are boiling away. I'm gonna go ahead and fry the cod. I also decided against baking it. So I have two pieces right here. One I will be eating right now. The other one I will be eating tomorrow. I'm just gonna pan fry it for about 15 minutes. I'm gonna add some lemon pepper and a little bit of regular pepper as well. And then a little bit of salt. Done. I'm just going to save that one for dinner tomorrow. This is what my plate looks like so far. I'm just waiting on the sweet potatoes, which are almost done. I'm just going to be adding some coconut oil into the sweet potatoes, just about 1 tablespoon. Quarter tablespoon. This is just what it turned out like. Super, super basic, honestly. This is as basic as it gets for dinner meals.